Dr. Elizabeth Boskey. I'm the STD expert at About.com and a sexuality writer, researcher, and educator, and I've been brought here to talk about waffles. I love waffles for breakfast with butter and syrup, and I'm getting an evil eye because I'm actually supposed to be talking about blue waffle. Now, if you haven't heard about blue waffle, you're probably over 30. I know that I hadn't heard about blue waffle until a couple of years ago. Someone sent me an email asking about this horrible STD that they're seeing all over the internet that turns a woman's vagina blue. Ah, very scary. Also, very fake. There was a possibility that there was an STD that I hadn't heard of. Being an STD educator for 20 years, it wasn't likely, but I checked. I did a lot of research. I can pretty assuredly tell you that there is no STD that's going to turn your vagina blue. However, while a lot of people think that this is a Photoshop fraud or something like that, or image manipulation, I actually have a theory about where the blue waffle urban legend came from. There used to be a common treatment for yeast infections called gentian violet, and people still use it occasionally. It's basically a purple stain that you paint on your skin that makes the yeast go away. They don't like the chemicals in it. And what it makes you look like is, Alex in the studio, this. See the blue hand? Doesn't that look an awful lot like what that picture of a blue vagina looks like? I think that's what was actually going on with the urban legend. So, blue waffle as an STD doesn't exist. Blueberry waffles as a breakfast food, excellent choice. And that's where the blue waffle urban legend came from, at least. That's what I think. There's no proof. It's an urban legend. We'll never know. We talk about blue waffle instead of blue Twinkie because we are a lot more concerned as a society about female sexuality. And that when kids talk about blue waffle as being a thing that girls who sleep around a lot get, it's because girls sleeping around is stigmatized in a way that boys sleeping around is not. And that we culturally have a lot invested in controlling female sexuality. And it's pretty scary to say to a girl, oh my God, you're gonna have a lot of sex, and then your vagina is gonna turn blue. Because first of all, not only is that a mark of shame for her, but that's a very visible mark of shame. Your vagina has turned blue, everyone will know that you've had sex. And that's a pretty strong cultural prohibition. And I think that's why we talk about blue waffle as opposed to blue Twinkie, because hey, if sex turned a guy's penis blue, most teenagers would be parading around going, hey, look, I'm a Smurf.
Lovers.